Hello. 27th of August today, and summer's back by the looks of it. It's very warm. Oh, look, I've got a little, another visitor here again.
A hungry one.
Eating them peas.
Eating all your food.
Right. So, here's one.
I can't think we're not going to hit that.
See you in a bit.
Dave at the allotment. Dave, what are you after this afternoon? Still cracking on at the allotment. Get the kettle on. It's Dave at the allotment. See you in a bit.
Well, there's not much to do in the allotment at this time of year. Don't let the sun fool your mind. It's been freezing for the past week. Hi, Tarzani. Shut up. So I'm going to... All my peas are finished and that. I'm going to pick up everything that needs to be done. And then I'll show you what I've got when I've finished. So I'll crack on with that. Follow me. All this needs to be burned. I trimmed back all them blackberry bushes there the other day, so that needs to be burned. And the peas are all finished now, so they can all come up. There might be one or two left there for Paula.
There's some hanging off the ones you've ripped out as well.
Aye, I'll get them. So I'll just crack on with this while Paula eats her peas. Yummers.
Ow.
So just pick off the ones that you've missed. Quite a few by the looks of it here. And then once you're done with that, just put the rest in the compost heap.
Under the pen sieve.
Hi. If you've seen Harry Potter, you'll know what a pen sieve is. Right, that's them. I'll put these in the compost bin. So. Crack on. See you in a bit.
Where did you come from?
I've been getting plenty of runner beans off. All different sizes. Quite late, but you know, they're still edible. Like I've said before, we're 6 weeks behind when it comes to the spring and what have you. But I'm getting loads off now. Been picking them every day. The only trouble is it gets...
Whoa. It gets whoa.
Uh-huh. It gets too bushy and you cannot see where all the beans are.
Around here. That's why.
Right, Well, that's all I can see for now. I have also been getting these Blue Lake climbing beans. Let's see if I can see any. I just picked all over there yesterday, like, so. I don't know if I've got any on ready. Oh no, here. Loads of these as well. Nice, just boiled, you know. A little bit of seasoning. That's them there. Dwarf, Blue Lake climbing beans. I've also been getting a load of these bolotti beans. Yeah, I'll try and get a thick one, mate. Now, I don't know, I remember these beans last year. They were sort of, are they too big or too small, I should I say? Can you see them? Are they too small? And I think they're supposed to get little, like, marbly sort of effect things on. I mean, they still taste alright, but if anyone can help us out with that, just put a comment in the comment box below. I'll see you in a bit.
Well, here we are again for afternoon tea. Again. Very posh, don't you know?
Isn't it?
So let's see what we get this time. We're in Whitley Bay now. Whitley Bay. For afternoon tea, yummers.
I'm starving.
Bring on the food. How to pour a perfect cup of tea.
Black tea.
Black tea.
For just pour it in. Just pour it in. Voila. And there it is.
There you go.
Thanks very much.
That's it done.
Job done.
Now this is how you make a proper cup of tea. Not too close. Pour.
No sugar nips.
Milk. No sugar nips here.
And sugar keys.
Just sachets.
Sachet. It's a what?
It's a sachet of sugar.
Sachet. Here comes the food, I'm going to stop it.
Here we go with afternoon tea.
Look at the size of that.
That's a sawney. What we've got here? Palm. Are you having any of that? Thanks.
Thank you.
As I was saying, sandwiches, sausage rolls and stuff, and a cup of tea.
Don't you know?
Don't you know? So I think I'll enjoy my cup of tea. A cup of tea and a slice of cake.
On. What? Enjoy. I will. Bye for now. It's like they did in the olden days. Cheers, Dee. Right, anyway, that's the savouries done. Now just waiting for cakes.
My favourite.
Cakes. Man, I love the cake. Where's the cakes? Here's my cakes. What do I have? Scones.
Scones
and clotted cream with jam and butter.
Butter.
A bit of what do you call it again?
Battenberg.
A little bit of caramel cake thing. A bit of donut and a couple of
shortbread.
A couple of shortbread biggies.
So it's time to do a cake swap.
So watch me eat the lot. Paula doesn't like donuts, so what does she get instead?
She gets Battenberg.
Battenberg? I might swap you one of them biscuits.
Alright.
Right.
So tight.
Cup of tea. Scones. Nice bit of scone with the jam on and that. Scones. I'll have one of these first.
Very nice. Putting on 3 stone here. Got a lump of strawberry.
Like a flapjack thing with chocolate on. Keep dripping. Homemade scones. Very posh. What do you think is having fun?
Yeah, you. I'm showing everybody it's showing you it.
Ah, do you know?
Can I have some more tea, please?
Yes, boss.
No. I said please.
Cup of tea.
The cup's there. Thank you. Thirsty.
Donut. Nice. So I'm going to enjoy the rest of this. So I'll catch you in a bit. It's all gone. Everything's gone.
Off my biscuit.
A very nice tattoo it was. I don't know. So while we're still in Whitley Bay, we're going to have a walk along the seafront. Show you a little bit of the sights.
See you later.
See you later. Well, here we are down on the seafront in Whitley Bay. Nice sunny day. It's been the nicest it's been all week, really. It's been raining and what have you. That's St Mary's Lighthouse over there. Somewhere. A nice, calm, peaceful sea. People shooting around these rocks like I used to do when I was a kid. There's a little rock pool thing down there. A nice, like I say, a nice calm, peaceful sea. Tide's out, be coming in soon. When the tide comes in, like it comes right now. Waves right over there.
So there's the gorgeous Paula. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Did you have a nice afternoon tea?
Yeah, I'm stuffed.
Yeah,
I like
so
getting blown out of office.
That's it, folks. Unless I say anything else of interest which you might like to know about, but I don't think so. Bye.
Bye.
Get off my land.
Nah.
Right. Sweet corn, take two. They weren't ready the last time because I picked them too early.
They've had another week, haven't they?
Yep. So, try again. Live on camera. Drum roll, please.
Oh, I should have had that.
Did you, I tell you to leave it here.
Oh, that's not a drum roll.
That looks like, no, that looks like a character off Button Moon.
Cornheed.
Cornheed. Mrs. Scraggy Top.
Right, I know for a fact this isn't going to work, like, but you know. Well, for starters, like I kept saying, there was supposed to be mini sweet corn for stir fries. Oh, it's the same. This one's exactly the same as the last one.
Hmm.
There's a few more on, like.
Got some hair on it.
Corn finger. Corn finger.
Wow, wow, wow.
See? Few and far between there, like. But I don't know. I think I'll leave the rest until it's the dead all together. Because the way to test if it's ready to eat as well. Prick one of the corns. And if it's milky liquid, which that is.
It's not ready.
It's ready.
Oh, it is ready.
Yeah, if it's milky, it's ready. And then if it's clear.
Oh, it's like squeezing a spot.
Ah, there, it is milky. You can see perfectly on there, that black nail varnish, perfect.
Oh, that was mint. Like a spot.
There's not much on there, like. I suppose it is mini sweet corn. But I'll have a taste anyway.
Oh my god. Rah.
Sorry.
Eating it rah. So really, it's not that good.
Nah. Chuck.
Cut.
Right, well, I totally forgot about these potatoes here. And you can hardly even see them anymore. Well, I didn't really forget about them. It's just I dug a few up in the past couple of weeks. There's hardly anything on them, so I didn't bother, you know what I mean? But I might as well dig the rest of these ones up. These are Morris paper. It's not a total failure.
Mm-mm. They look alright.
Aye.
I hope I can have some.
Yeah.
Potatoes. Boil them, mash them, put them in the stew.
Aye. Tea.
And what's that off?
Tea. It is. Lord of the Rings.
We had a Harry Potter one earlier.
Hobbit's food. Boring old hobbit's food. So, About 10. Not bad, but not good.
It's arid.
And due for a meal. Whoever this meal is. People keep mentioning them. I want to know who Emil is, me. Emil, if you're watching this, I want to know who you are, because you seem to be getting quite a lot of food. Worst joke ever, eh?
Did you see the tumbleweed blow past? Yeah, the wind.
Is that the wind impression? Quite good. Now, if you do it from one side to the other.
That wasn't me, that was the wind.
Twin speakers, man. Twin mics. Right, I'm going to...
Twin mics. So we had nearly give both your twins mic. Mic one and mic two, was it?
Who's
me?
Right.
So sad.
Cut. There's the last of my potatoes there. Not bad, I suppose. I'll give them a quick wash up. Get the kettle on and I'll... Although I don't know, I haven't got any coffee. So I'll just have to drink...
All time.
Because we're going to the cinema tonight to watch a film. Obviously.
Really?
Yeah.
With some giant nachos.
Deliver us from evil. See what that's like.
I'll have to hold his hand to be popping his knickers. He'll be hiding behind us.
Right, anyway, have a good time for this.
To be embarrassed by me.
So I'm going to wash these, and I'm going to get some tomatoes. So, see you in a bit. Right, that's it. Jackie, you're no good to me no more. That's it.
Relationship break up.
You're just getting in the way of things now, so it's time for you to go. Good secretaries there, Blake.
Bloody awful spider, I've just seen it.
Bye, Jackie.
Would everybody like a moment's silence? Yeah.
He may
remember
return.
The life of Jackie.
He may return.
Oh, hello.
Are you filming? All right.
Another, what do you mean? Another stop?
Well,
sneaky.
My tomatoes have had it as well. So I'm picking them now, and that's it. Done for the year. I kind of complain like I've had loads of these.
Aye, hiya. Oh, dirty fingers.
Let's go and see what Paula's up to. Oh, it's much better now that Jackie's gone. Can walk past with ease. Oh, are you getting some tomatoes, are you? Yeah, these are the last of my tomatoes here. I've had a load off, like an absolute load. So I'm just going to strip them bare and then get rid of them. But I also have quite a few cucumbers. Nice. Can you goodens them, like? The taste are eating all. My grapes are doing fine as well. I keep going to this bunch because it's the closest one. Oh, aye.
Start the colour.
As you can see, as Paul has just pointed out there. They've just started turning, which is good. There was one ripe the other day. I tried it, I ate it, it was nice. The skin was a bit thick like. In fact, there's one here. Let's see if I can get it.
There's more up there, one or two, what you see, at the top, yeah.
Is that ripe? Now it needs to go a little bit darker than that, but do you want to try?
No, I don't want to try it.
I will. Go on. It's bitter.
Mm-hmm. But nice at the same time.
They're not bad, right? You know, I'll give them a couple of weeks. But a month's time, they'll be...
Right.
So...
I'll carry on if you let me out there. You can carry on in here.
So I'm just going to strip these off now, like I say. Take them cucumbers off. And sit and wait for my grapes to ripen.
Not literally.
There's quite a few there, so I did make a video the other day, the day before my birthday. I might upload that. In fact, I probably will, because it took a while to do. And Tony, I've got a little question for you. I did that handbrake thing. It does.
What are you doing?
I don't know if you're.
No, I can see you. Come on, Newman.
I uploaded that handbrake. It does shorten the gigabyte of the actual movie. But the thing is, it's uploading to the YouTube, which takes an absolute age. It's getting longer and longer for some reason. I think I must have to give my computer a good clean or something. There's Paula nodding her head there. So anyway, I'll get on with this because it's nearly time for the pictures.
I needed freshening up.
Yeah, I need to go in the shower now. Have a little bit of a shave me cheeks.
Your neck.
I might shave me hair. So.
What hair?
The hair that I just shaved off the other day.
That's what I mean, what hair?
So anyway, folks, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing and all that kind of thing. See you in a bit.